Good evening. Welcome to yet another favorites video. This time it's going to be in a soft spoken style. And I would love to change them back and forth between whisper and soft spoken on a monthly basis. So the principle for these videos is that I'm going to be doing them in the style of back to basics, which means the least amounts of editing, no soundproofing, using the easiest equipment, which is like this microphone right now. I'm going to have no script, so it's as authentic, as genuine as it can be. And I would love to make these monthly because they're fun for me to make, and I hope you might enjoy them as well. This monthly favorites is going to include a favorite piece of jewelry or crystal, my favorite application on the phone for this month that I happen to use a lot lately. Also, we're going to talk about astrology and my journey with astrology. Also, I'm going to pull out a tarot card for this month. I've been enjoying tarot cards for a while, so I would love to add this to these videos. And also, I'm going to show you some piece of cosmetics that I've been enjoying. So, let's start. So we're going to start with some nice and gentle tapping on this beautiful vinyl surface. Yet again, but not in a whisper this time, more of a soft spoken. So this is going to be more of a sounds video than sleepy video. Hope that's okay. Let's do some up close to the microphone tapping. Such a gentle sound. Okay. Time I'm wearing a very black shade with some sparkles. I'll put the name of the nail polish in the description. It actually matches very well my sweater, which has sequins and is gray and black too. So okay, so let's start with the first objects. Here we have some sticky fingers. I'll start with the first thing that I have here, and that's a piece of cosmetics. So this is peeling gel. And what I love about this one is that you apply it on dry skin. You rub it in for just about a minute, and then you just wash it off, and it gives you the most wonderful polishing effect. I use this every other day because it is not a strong scrub. It's not even a scrub at all. If anything, you get it polishes your face, but still exfoliates it in the most gentle way. So, and it's quite natural. It has apple, lemon, orange extracts. It's a deep cleaning peeling gel. I found it this month and I've already used up a bunch, but relate to this one. Okay, so thoroughly cleanse and dry face. Apply the product to face and massage evenly, except for eyes and mouth. Rinse with warm water after 1 minute. So that's pretty cool. Just as a suggestion. Then I'm going to show you an application. I know this is quite a fast video compared to my previous ones. Once again, this one's not necessarily perfect for sleep. Okay. So, I have my phone. This is the list for today's video. Oh, come on. Okay. So, the application that I wanted to show you today is called Fabulous. And it looks like this. I actually have been using this for a couple of months now. Maybe even like 3 months or so. And I use it every day. So, how you do this is you set up an account. It's a free application. On Android at least, I'm not sure about other things. And you set up your daily rituals, and it helps you to push through and organizes your life. It sets up alarms for you, so you can choose that. So for example, I have a morning routine, which I'm not sure if you can see this, which is stretching for 8 minutes, and then write my to-do list. It's going to be quite a loud one, but okay, I'll show it to you. So it starts like this. And then you have 8 minutes to stretch. So you can either take their pre-made stretch, which is yoga stretch, or what I do is I use this app called Works, I think, and I just go to their stretches, and I do like some of these stretches. And once I'm done, I click back. It takes me back to this app. So this is my next goal: write my to-do list. And again, I have 10 minutes to do so, to organize my day, schedule everything for the day. And then, you know, once I'm done, I click on continue. So my afternoon has two rituals, which are what are my three most important tasks. So I would look back at my list from the morning, see which ones have to be done that day, which ones I can skip. This one is to exercise. I either go to the gym, or you can pick one of their quick workouts, like 7 minute, 1 minute, 3 minute. I really love the sounds of this application. Then we have evening ritual. So this one is be grateful. So for 10 minutes, I need to sit down and say out loud or write down things that I am grateful for. And I do this daily, and it's quite a nice practice to do, because for 10 minutes, that's a long time. And you really sit down and you go much deeper in your appreciation of your life than you have ever thought, because you're almost pressured to find things to be grateful for. not just the surface things, but deeper things, so that's wonderful. And the next one is adjust and review plans, which is when I finalize all of my things that I've done that day, what can be pushed to the next day, and so forth. But you can add multiple amounts of different types of things. So you can add all of these meditations. I love their meditations, by the way. Let me show you. So again, they give you 4 different meditations that you can do if you set up this ritual. For example, this one is just quiet. But it's an organized quiet. Or, let me see, I think this one's guided. And it has a wonderful, beautiful voice as well. Well, you get the idea. So, I do really suggest everyone to check it out if possible. I'm not affiliated with them in any way. I would love to be, but I'm not. This is just my suggestion. I really love this app. Okay, let's do the next one. Okay, so the next favorite is a crystal. This month, my favorite crystal is Red Jasper. This jasper is in the shape of a point. And it has wonderful energy to it. This one's a polished tumbled stone, same way to also jasper. So just 2 different forms to show you. Now, I hope I don't have to explain myself and say that it is completely fine not to appreciate crystals or other things. We all are passionate about something in life. Some people love gaming. Some people love ASMR videos. Some people love meditations, some people love yoga, some people love going to church, some people love all of these together, and, just like me, I also love crystals. I don't worship them, but I have a great appreciation for them. They make me feel nice and good. So, today we're going to learn a little bit about this crystal, which is red jasper. And I have my book that we're going to flip through. Okay. Let me show this to you. So, jasper itself is known as the supreme nurturer. It sustains and supports during times of stress, brings a tranquility and wholeness, used in healing. It unifies all aspects of your life. Jasper reminds people to help each other. It aligns the chakras, can be used in chakra layouts. Each color is appropriate to a specific chakra. Absorbs negative energy. Let me just read you about Red Jasper. Okay. Red Jasper is gently stimulating. It grounds energy and rectifies unjust situations. Red Jasper brings problems to light before they become too big, and provides insight into the most difficult situations. He makes an excellent worry bead, calming the emotions when played with. Placed under the pillow, it helps dream recall. Red Jasper stimulates the base chakra and assists rebirthing. It cleans and stabilizes the aura and strengthens your boundaries. This is a stone of health, strengthening and detoxifying the circulatory system, the blood and liver. It dissolves blockages in the liver and bile ducts. Something here also. Healing properties. Jasper supports the circulatory, digestive, and sexual organs. It balances the mineral content of the body. It is particularly useful as a gem elixir because it does not overstimulate the body. So, physically, Jasper prolongs sexual pleasure, supports during prolonged illnesses or hospitalization, and re-energizes the body. So, just some information for you for this month about this beautiful stone. This is the stone for me that I chose for this month for myself. So, I just kind of hang with it a bit here and there as much as I can. You can either carry it with you like a bead and just rub it if you're worried, or you can just look at it, or you can just have it somewhere sitting around. With the stone, and we can pick one stone every month, and I can talk about it a little bit, and hopefully you might learn something new about these. This way, yeah. Once again, you don't have to believe anything. You don't have to believe me. You don't have to believe no one if you don't want to. We all have our choices and wishes. All you can do, all you can choose to do is to respect other people's wishes and other people's choices, if you wish your choices to be respected as well. So, I can say it like this. ASMR community is not believed fully to exist, but I know I feel the tingles, but nobody can still prove it. Only you and me can prove it, right? So, it's a similar way. If you don't feel it, then it's not for you, and that's okay. But hopefully you can learn something interesting. Okay. Let's continue. So, very much in line with spirituality. Recently, I have started to take astrology classes, and I wanted to show you what I've learned so far. So this is just my notebook where I just kind of practiced writing symbols and glyphs and such. And this one is my folder. So, let me do a little walk through for you. So, on this page, we have, again, symbols and names for the planets, the different symbols and aspects. This one was my quiz. I needed to like read these or write these sentences and symbols. Then we have a description of the houses. In the future sometime, I would love to do a little walkthrough for you to show you how to kind of read things around. Not right now, but maybe in the future. So again, you see we have first house, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, we have a description of all of these houses, and I'll show you where to see them. And this one is interpretation for certain planets in certain houses. So what first, in the first house, what a certain planet could possibly represent. Of course, it's a very broad description, but it does help. And these are actually circles with the houses, so from 1 through 12. And again, it has these descriptions for this house. Just some other things here. So these are very short summaries for the planets. Again, just as a note for yourself of what the planets represent in a way. Same thing for the signs. So if you would like to, you can read real quick. Which a sign represents, and the last word mostly is a negative, so don't feel discouraged. Then we learned about different modalities or qualities of all signs, that they can be three types of them: cardinal, fixed, mutable. Also, we learned the four elements that the signs fall under: fire, earth, air, and water. And a little description for all of them. I can go in depth later. More information about the planets. Okay. And so these two are my natal charts. It's the same thing, just this one's more in depth. So, this is my chart for Maria. 2 a.m. in the morning, 22nd July, 86, in Lipetsk. And my sun is 20 degrees in Cancer, 49 minutes. My ascendant sign is in Gemini. My moon is in Aquarius. So that's something that I learned about myself. Also, my sun and Mercury are in the third house, which kind of in a way represents that my individuality comes from my style of communication, in a sense. At least that's how I interpreted it, which kind of makes sense, because I do ASMR videos. So my self, my individuality, my difference comes from the way I communicate, so that's good. Again, I'm only learning, so I can't talk about too much depth yet. And here we have more details where it shows different elements and aspects. So all types of opposition and conjunction and trines and squares and all that stuff. So you would read all of these in a combination of things. So there's a lot of stuff to actually learn through this. It would take me a long time to read this as a beginner. Also, I know that some people actually have looked at my natal chart as well, and they believe that this is not accurate. I can't really say much because I'm just a beginner. My date and time are definitely correct because I have asked my mother a million times, and she always says the same thing, so I kind of trust her. So I can't really say much more, but a lot of people think that I'm not a Gemini, I'm more of a Leo, but I can't really prove it, so I don't know. I can't say much more. I guess I'll find out in the future. So that's that. I know I talk a lot in this video. I appreciate you being patient with me. And the last thing we're going to look at are tarot cards. I've been working with this deck for quite some time now. I like tarot cards. They're very nice and gentle inspiration for me. So this is our book. I still have to read the book. I cannot read myself the cards yet. Okay. But the cards are very beautiful. They have this golden edge to them. and a beautiful imagery. Yes, some of them are upside down on purpose. I mean, I don't do that, but these are for readings, so. I think that the imagery is absolutely beautiful. So much in depth. This is a beautiful, beautiful deck. You'll pay attention, there's always so much more detail that you can pick out. Sorry, my hand is a little shaky. Very interesting. So it's always uplifting and always guiding, and it's never a negative message, I promise you. Just like in real life, nothing is truly a negative experience. Every experience should be treasured, good and bad, because it's all a lesson. Okay, so I'm going to shuffle them up. And we're going to ask the cards to give us one message for this month, and we're going to read it, okay? So, hello cards. Please give us a message for this month, for me and my viewers on YouTube, my friends. What is one message that we need to hear this month? One message that we need to hear this month, please. What is one message that we need to hear this month? What is one message that we need to hear this month? What is one message that we need to hear this got a forward facing card, which is Wizard of Awareness. One of the cards that we just actually looked at. So let's read a description for it. You can so far think of what do you think the message is. Do you feel it represents? Okay. And I'm going to find it and read it. Okay. Your soul knows best. Be still and observe. Mindfulness is about being observant and remaining neutral about what goes on in the world around you. This applies to the environment within you too. If you struggle inside yourself, stepping into an observer position gives you a new, powerful perspective that neutralizes any discomfort or overexcitement. You have the capacity to see things clearly now, unencumbered by opinion or desire. Wearing the world as a loose garment requires you to adopt a sense that nothing that happens to you is personal. Just what I was saying to you just now. People come and go. Experiences evolve from one state to another in a continual shifting and change no matter what. And change no matter how much you want things to stay the same. The Wizard of Awareness asks you to give up your need to define or limit what you're experiencing now. It's all good. Let it be. And watch the miracle unfold without any direct influence from you. So basically, what it tells you is to loosen up your control a bit, let things happen the way they are unfolding, be ready and open for change, and don't take it too close to heart, no matter what change is. Because again, in all reality, I'll tell you what. Let me just put this away. Thank you, cards. In all reality, I think personally, change is always great. And I'll give you an example. What type of memories do you have about your life? Do you remember what you've done every day, all the time? Or do you remember mostly what has happened that was a shifting experience? Whether it was a good one or a bad one, this is what your memories become, is the change. If there is no change, again, good or bad, let me focus the camera, then there will be no memories for you. There's almost nothing exciting. Again, things always happen. Things always work out. One thing stops, another thing starts. As cheesy as that sounds, that is true. So you should always try and live just a little bit more light and not take things way too seriously, because everything can change very quickly. So you should never have stubborn expectations, I want to say. You should try to live a little bit lighter, less attachment to things, less attachment to people. I'm not talking about your family, obviously. But have a little bit more transparent view sometimes, and let things happen as they are happening, because it's just a transition onto something else. Okay, I'll stop talking. I talked a lot in this video. I know it's not extremely relaxing, but I want to do this video today for you, so I guess I should say it's for you and for me. I think I needed to talk to you, so Thank you so much for keeping me company, for sticking around. I really love you and really appreciate you. Thank you for all of your support. Goodbye.